Information Services Corporation has revealed a solid finish to 2015 despite tougher market conditions. The Saskatchewan-based registry and information services provider saw total revenue in the final quarter of last year rise 14% to 22.6 million Canadian dollars, while underlying earnings of EBITDA advanced 16% to 8.2 million Canadian dollars. Well, for more, I'm joined by the President and Chief Executive, Jeff Stusek. So, Jeff, as I've said in the introduction, you are a Saskatchewan-based company, and of course, the local economy heavily dependent on an energy industry which is reeling from the collapse in the oil prices. So, how did your business prevail and prosper against such a backdrop?
Well, we take a pretty simple approach to business. If we see pressures on the top on our revenue line, we have to take action to manage costs, to make choices, to ensure that our investors get a solid return, our EBITDA and our net income remain solid. I think it's important to understand that oil prices, although negative in our economy, aren't a key driver necessarily. The Saskatchewan economy where we live is oil based in some ways, but it's not completely that. We have a strong manufacturing sector and other aspects of the economy. So some of the negative news that we see around oil prices as it relates to Western Canada really apply more to our neighbor in Alberta than it does in Saskatchewan. Certainly does have an effect, but not at a profound effect that we're seeing next door for sure.
Okay, so would you say that diversification is key to your resilience? You know, part of your strategy has included acquisitions, namely ESC Corporate Services. Was that company immediately cash generative?
Yeah, it was. So part of our strategy is we don't want to be, and I think it's poor business strategy to be reliant on a single jurisdiction's economy. And so diversification is important. So our acquisition of ESC, unfortunate acronym given that we're ISC, we bought a company named ESC, but they're in a similar line of business for us in a different geography, and that diversification really helped. And so as we were facing some tough times in 2015, in the latter years, that was offset by some good numbers from our ESC acquisition that we acquired on October 1st of last year.
Okay, so I'm just wondering if there's more acquisitions to come and whether they're reliant on having similar sounding acronyms to yours. But, you know, are there any other distressed assets out there that you could get at a discount?
You know, we're not looking necessarily for distressed assets. We're looking for assets that complement what we do and enhance what we're doing from a strategic standpoint. So part of that strategy is to diversify our revenue and geography. So we're looking for businesses that are solid, that actually complement what we do, but are aligned to the way we approach business. And so ESC was very attractive to us because they approach their customers in the same way we do. And so they want an elated customer and they want a repeat customer and customers that become advocates for them. And that's the ISC way of doing that as well. So there was a cultural alignment as well that became important. So it's not just about distressed assets and picking up a good deal. It's about acquiring companies that are aligned to where we're going, quite frankly. And so there possibly is more, but it's got to be the right fit for us.
So okay, so we've talked about the acquisitions, but what about the overall growth strategy for the business?
So ISC has a very strong perspective on growth, and we have high hopes for the company as we continue to move it forward. So acquisitions is one of those where we're acquiring companies that have service elements that we want to build on. I think another aspect of our growth is we run some core government services on behalf of the government in the jurisdictions we run. Registries, specifically land registry, corporate registry, personal property registry, on behalf of the province of Saskatchewan. We do that very well in a world-class manner. And so we've spent a lot of time and are working on jurisdictions to help them understand the value in that and where we can add some value. So part of our growth strategy is really to try to replicate what we do in Saskatchewan in other jurisdictions. whether they be in Canada or elsewhere around the globe.
Okay, I kind of like that idea of you recruiting ambassadors and advocates for your business. But you know, what are the main challenges and opportunities for the business in 2016? Or is the model partially tied up with economic growth?
You know, in some ways, there is nothing we can do about the economics of the jurisdictions that we're in. And so it's foolish to chase that. What we have to do is run the business fantastically well, and we're going to continue to do that, continue to have fantastic customers. I think great businesses survive tough times through sort of core fundamentals, which is take care of your customers, make good business decisions, don't be foolish with your spend, and good businesses survive tough economic times, and I'm confident we will too.
Okay, and many good businesses also pay a dividend. Investors are being rewarded by a dividend by yourselves. Is this a policy that's set to continue?
Yeah, our board has a policy. We pay an 80-cent annual dividend. It's a way of rewarding our shareholders, if you will, and it's just part of the business model when we came out as the IPO that some of our cash flow is going to be diverted to dividends. We think that's a prudent approach for our business, and it works for us and it works for our shareholders.
Lovely. Jeff Stusek, Chief Executive and President of Information Services Corporation. Thank you very much indeed for joining us today.
Thank you very much.